Now, the House of Representatives becomes the latest victim of a cyber attack involving a government entity. The official website of the House of Representatives was defaced Sunday, with a certain Three Musketeers claiming the hacking. House Secretary General Reginald Velasco confirmed the cyber attack. He says they are coordinating with the ICT department to address the matter. The website remains inaccessible. Meanwhile, the DICT says it may soon identify suspects behind the cyber attacks on government agencies. The Philippine Statistics Authority, PhilHealth, and the Science and Technology Department have reported cases of data breach in recent weeks.
Still, we believe these to be local actors, and we're actually, we already have a lead. We're pursuing suspects. The threat actors are skilled hackers. But yes, you're right. It seems that they're working independently and they're not as sophisticated as the one that we monitored during the Medusa attack of PhilHealth.
China continues to flex its maritime might in the West Philippine Sea. The Philippine Navy warned off and issued radio challenges to a Chinese vessel after it shadowed Manila's BRP Benguet at an 80-yard distance Friday. The Philippine vessel was en route to Rizal Reef Station for the conduct of a regular rotation and resupply mission when the incident happened. The armed forces of the Philippines slammed China's latest maritime harassment, saying it endangers the lives of people at sea. Beijing maintains claims over the Philippine waters despite an arbitral ruling that already invalidated its sweeping claims. The Philippine government places the war-torn Gaza under alert level 4, ordering Filipinos there to evacuate. Israel has ordered civilians in the besieged enclave to flee south amid an expected ground offensive. Some 131 Filipinos are residing in Gaza.
Sabihin na namin sa inyo, lumikas na kayo. At kung maiwan kayo, well, we can't stop you, we cannot prevent it. Pero nasa inyo na yan kung may mangyari sa inyo. Kasi gigirahin na sila ng Israel.
Meanwhile, alert level 2 remains in Israel, where around 30,000 Filipinos are residing. The first batch of the 22 Filipinos asking to be repatriated was supposed to go home today, but their flight was moved Tuesday. Three Filipinos were confirmed killed in the conflict between Hamas and Israel, while another three remain unaccounted for. Israel's prime minister vowing to demolish Hamas as troops prepare to move into Gaza Strip. Benjamin Netanyahu made that vow Sunday as he convened Israel's wartime cabinet for the first time. Israel is preparing for a new phase in its deadly war against Hamas militants, gearing up for what it called significant ground operations after a week of pounding Gaza with crippling airstrikes. Israeli troops and equipment are now at the border in Gaza in preparation for the ground offensive.
ראיתי את הלוחמים הנפלאים שלנו.
I saw our wonderful fighters who are now on the front line. They know that the whole nation is behind them. They understand the magnitude of the task. They are ready to act at any moment to eradicate the bloody monsters that have risen up against us to kill us. Hamas thought we would be demolished. It is we who will demolish Hamas.
אנחנו נפרק את החמאס.
Israel launched its offensive in response to the brutal attacks of Hamas last week that killed over 1,400 people on their side. On Sunday, an Israeli aircraft struck about 250 military targets in Gaza, killing the Hamas Southern District Commander. Over now to the deteriorating situation in Gaza, the death toll there now at 2,600. At least Israel's unforgiving response continues. Ice cream trucks turned into morgues, since bringing the bodies into hospitals becomes increasingly risky, while cemeteries are short of space. Nearly 10,000 people in Gaza were wounded, while another 1,000 were missing and believed to be under rubble. Palestinians are also facing serious shortages of clean water and food. Diplomatic efforts to address the crisis are intensifying, while Egypt facing pressure to open a humanitarian corridor. The U.S. renews calls to ensure the safe passage of innocent civilians fleeing the war between Israel and Hamas militants. This as concerns of a regional conflict grow, with the U.S. issuing strong warnings to Iran. More in this report.
The Israel Defense Forces have underscored their determination to destroy Hamas in its entirety following the militant group's deadly incursion into Israel on October 7. They also renewed calls for Palestinian civilians to evacuate the northern part of Gaza before strikes by Israel intensify. The IDF's spokesperson, Lieutenant Colonel Peter Lerner, was interviewed on ABC.
We are seeing that people are actually evacuating. Indeed, we would like to see the humanitarian organizations assisting in the evacuation of people for the welfare of people and not side with Hamas, telling them not to evacuate.
With more than 1 million Palestinian civilians potentially trying to move out of harm's way, the United States is working with its partners to ensure the humanitarian needs of the displaced are being met, said White House National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan on ABC's This Week.
We are in touch with our Israeli counterparts. We're in touch with the United Nations to help secure the necessary supplies of food, water, and medicine to the citizens of Gaza, those Palestinians who have nothing to do with the barbaric terrorists who carried out this attack.
The exchange of fire continued over the weekend at the Israeli border with Lebanon, where the Iran-backed militia Hezbollah operates. Republican Lindsey Graham, who plans to visit the region in the coming days with a bipartisan group of U.S. senators, issued a strong warning against Tehran and its allies, intending to play a more active role in the conflict.
If Hezbollah, which is a proxy of Iran, launches a massive attack on Israel, I would consider that a threat to the state of Israel, existential in nature. I will introduce a resolution in the United States Senate to allow military action by the United States in conjunction with Israel to knock Iran out of the oil business. Iran, if you escalate this war, we're coming for you.
Meanwhile, as part of a regional tour aimed at diffusing tensions, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken met Sunday with Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. They both agreed on the importance of ensuring assistance to the Palestinian civilians fleeing the war, according to spokesperson Matthew Miller. Blinken is expected to travel again to Israel on Monday for further consultations. Veronica Valderas Iglesias, VOA News, Washington.
Another 6.3 magnitude quake rocks Afghanistan, killing at least 4 people and injuring over 100 more. This disaster follows a pair of tremors that killed thousands of Afghans recently.
Afghans are once again bringing their injured to hospitals as the country suffers its third magnitude 6.3 earthquake in just over a week. The U.S. Geological Survey says the quake's epicenter was about 34 kilometers outside the provincial capital, Herat. Authorities report a handful of people dead and at least 150 injured, according to the head of the emergency relief team, who cautioned those numbers may rise as rescuers reach more affected areas. Some in Herat had already been sleeping in tents following last week's earthquakes that killed thousands and leveled buildings. They say they don't feel safe returning home.
We have been staying on the road for the last 5 or 6 days since the first quake struck because our homes are not strong enough. So we came out living here for fear of more quakes.
The United Nations says aid deliveries have been underway as of midweek, but they fall far short of Afghanistan's needs.
This is a disaster on top of a disaster on top of a disaster on top of a disaster. Currently, we have 15 million people who do not know where their next meal will come from. And the World Food Program is only able to support 3 million people due to a massive funding shortfall. So we're really calling on the international community to support the Afghan people, stand in solidarity, and also support the World Food Program.
Despite budget shortfalls, the UN says it may consider cash distributions in the coming weeks. Afghanistan's healthcare system widely relies on foreign aid, which has been drying up since the Taliban took control more than 2 years ago. Arash Arabasadi, VOA News.